If you look at some viruses, they're spherical, they look neat, they look very geometric. If you look at Ebola under an electron microscope, it looks like this really angry, ugly thing, which is befitting the devastating damage that this particular virus can do to the human species.
We have an immune system that's meant to be our first line defense. But Ebola kind of tricks them and makes them think that it's a friend instead of an enemy. And so the very cells that are meant to protect us are the ones that actually kind of let us down.
The virus is able to rapidly replicate and take over the machinery that your cell uses. And eventually the virus escapes from the cell, and that sets off a cascade where more and more cells are infected in a very rapid and sort of uncontrolled way.
It really has a predilection for the cells that line the blood vessels. Ebola destroys the blood vessel, so things start to leak out, and that's how it causes damage to nearly every single organ in the body. Ebola literally starves them of oxygen.
It's not really possible to identify Ebola when it first emerges, because when the initial patients are infected, it appears like any other tropical disease.
Vague flu-like illness. People get a fever and they ache all over.
These are all things that we associate with malaria, measles, and a couple of other diseases. It's not like you get a big red bump on your head that says Ebola.
After about day 5, when the patient enters the gastrointestinal phase, we begin to see the enormous amounts of body fluid which come out of them. And that fluid is highly contagious.
Ebola looks like really bad food poisoning that doesn't go away.
We'll see patients develop kidney failure, liver failure. And then a certain percentage of the patients go on to have what we call hemorrhagic fever. Not being able to clot and start bleeding out of their intestines and other parts of their body. And all of that compounds into organ collapse and death in the patient.
It's a very cruelly efficient virus that does its damage very rapidly. The average time from the first day that they have symptoms to death is usually 8, 9, 10 days.
As you get sicker and sicker, and if you ultimately die, the amount of virus in your body increases, and you become more and more infectious.
It's almost as if the virus realizes, okay, you know, our host is dead, let's all jump ship, and they're all over the outside of that body.
And so, tragically, when a person dies of Ebola, the body remains very, very infectious to somebody else. And so that is a huge risk, as we saw in West Africa.